Yo, what is up, Clan Wars? And Clan Wars events are going on right now on the global map called the Renaissance. It lasts from the 11th of January to the 25th of January, just another 5 more days to go. And I get a lot of questions right now regarding this Clan Wars events, mostly about what kind of reward tanks are they, which ones to get, what kind of tanks do I need if I want to play Clan Wars. So in today's video, I am going to talk about these tanks, and I'm going to talk about the reward tanks, and I'm going to talk about the tank picks, tanks that you need, tanks that are going to get you the most games if you are playing Clan Wars and trying to earn yourself one of these reward tanks. Now, I'm on the Clan Wars page here, and these are the rewards for this season's lucky winners. In the Asia region, you get 1,500 lucky players who are going to earn themselves one of these tanks. In your region, you could get more or less tanks, less players getting those rewards. But these are the six tanks that are available for you to pick at the end of the event. The newest tank being this one, the Italian Carro di Combattimento. The rest of these tanks are all old tanks. Now, the one tank that you don't see here, and the one tank that most people want, is the Chieftain T95. Now, in terms of hierarchy, the Chieftain T95 is the number one tank pick. You want that tank if you can get your hands on that tank. And that's why it is not included in 2021's January tank rewards, because a lot of people have them, a lot of people want them, they want to make that tank a little bit more special, I guess, so they're holding it back and they are not allowed to pick that tank. Now, in terms of hierarchy, the T95 Chieftain is the number one pick. If you already have that tank, your second choice should always be the Object 907 as your reward tank. If you're lucky enough, if you're one of the 1,500 people that will be able to pick up one reward tank, it's got to be the Object 907 from this iteration of Clan Wars. Your third choice will probably be the VK7201K. Now, why do you pick them in this order? Why Chieftain and then the 907 and then the VK and not the rest? Well, it works this way. The more reward tanks of these, if you have the Chieftain and you have the 907, the more likely you are able to collect the rest of these tanks here. And I'm going to show you why. Now, as you can see, I have already all the tanks, and I also have the Chieftain, so I already have all the tanks. For me, I'm only picking up the Italian Carro Combattimento. So for me, I'm going to pick this tank because I've already got everything else. But if you are new, this is the tank you're going to pick, the 907. And that's because you can't pick the Chieftain. All right. And if you already have the 907, your third tank would probably be this one, the VK7201K. And I'll get to why right now. So today we are going to review the tanks. Well, I'm going to rate the tanks on how useful all the tier 10 tanks are, and I'm going to rate them this way: your main tanks, and then your second tier are going to be support tanks and lock tanks. Lock tanks meaning sometimes you have your main tanks locked, you don't have any other choice, you have to play your secondary support tanks. These are your second choice tanks, these are your third choice tanks. And here's a bunch of tanks that never ever get picked for Clan Wars. And the last but not least, these are the meme tanks, the tanks that you pick just for fun, just to have fun in the game. They're not really competitive, but you play them in Clan Wars just for fun. So let's go straight to the main tanks. Now, the main tanks are going to be these five tanks. When I say main tanks, I mean these five tanks are picked all the time. The first one being the Chieftain T95. I told you how important this tank is. This is the most important tank. Almost every game will feature a Chieftain, if not five Chieftains. I dare to say around roughly five Chieftains are picked every game. Now, I know not every clan pick Chieftains. I know not every clan pick Chieftains as their first main battle tank. That's because they don't have the Chieftain. Any competitive clan, the top 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clans in Clan War events, this would be their main battle tank. You need to have this tank so that you can get other battle, so that you can get other reward tanks. You know what I mean? So this is one of the strongest tanks in the game, if not the strongest. So the Chieftain is the number one pick. You need a Chieftain to get yourself games. If you don't have a Chieftain, you are limiting your opportunities to play on the Clan Wars events. But have no fear, there are other tanks available. The second most popular tank is the 907. Again, every Clan Wars event, every advances, every competitive mode, you're going to see a minimum of three 907s in each battle. So you're going to have Chieftains, you're going to have 907s, that's guaranteed. The third most popular tank, now this tank you don't need to play Clan Wars events to earn. This is the Object 279E. You can grind this out in your random battles and earn yourselves a 279E. This tank, of course, another one of the most strongest powerful tanks in Clan Wars or any competitive mode. You always get picked if you have this tank. Although they don't pick 279Es in numbers, maybe 1, 2, maximum 5, I don't know. They don't get picked as much as Chieftains because it lacks a little bit of mobility, but it is the third most popular tank in Clan Wars. So if this is the third most popular tank, the fourth most popular tank, I think it's actually the EBR. You definitely have one EBR or sometimes two or even three EBRs in every game. So if you have an EBR, this you can grind. You can definitely grind this and get this and get yourself picked in Clan Wars. They always play EBRs. The fifth tank that is the main battle tanks, main battle tank category, or the first pick category, is the Conqueror Gun Carrier. It has a huge arc. You can shoot behind buildings. You can splash tanks that are 50 feet away. You can do damage all the time with a Conqueror Gun Carrier. It is the number one picked artillery piece. Every game you are going to get probably one at least RT or two CGCs. So these are the top five main battle tanks that you will definitely need. Now if you have all five of these tanks, your chances of being selected to play in every game goes up dramatically. If you are a good player, you're almost guaranteed a slot on any team. But if you're not a good player and you have five of these tanks, you are going to get a lot of games because these tanks are very powerful. They are very forgiving. They do consistent damage. They have trollish armor. They're reliable, and that's why they get picked a lot. Now the second layer of tanks here, I call them support tanks or locked tanks. Why? Support tanks means they are second pick tanks. If you don't have these five tanks, they will pick from these secondary tanks. Or if you are playing on the elite front, some of your tanks get locked because if you died, you get yourself killed, your tanks can be locked for 35 hours sometimes. And if you get locked for 35 hours, the next day's battles, you have no tanks to play, you have to play secondary tanks. And these are the secondary tanks. They include, for artillery, it's the Object 261 and the GWE-100. GWE-100, far less. Object 261, far more. In fact, the 261 is probably in between main tank and secondary tank kind of category. It gets picked a lot. The GWE, not that much. Now, the VKK, secondary tank, but it is used a lot in, especially on city maps like Ensk, Himmelsdorf, Ruinberg. Object 277, a mobile fast heavy tank. Normally, if you don't have a Chieftain, they will ask you to pick a 277. The 277 is the main heavy tank after the Chieftain. The 60TP, another slow heavy tank, but these are the heavy tanks that are in the same category as the VKK and the E100. They play in Ensk, they play in Himmelsdorf, they play in Ruinberg. Object 260 is a fast heavy tank. You can play them in big open spaces like Westfield Steps, where you need to traverse a lot of terrain to get to the place where you want to battle. Object 260 is a very popular fast heavy tank, which just as good as a 277. So if you don't have a Chieftain, they'll ask you to pick a 277 or an Object 260. Another advantage of the 260 is standard ammunition is APCR, which means you have a very high speed trajectory, high velocity standard APCR shells, which means you can shoot EBRs easier, you can snipe from a distance easier because you have a very fast shell velocity. Now I'm speaking as fast as I can because I don't want this video to go on too long. Now E100 heavy tank, recently buffed, a lot of armor. The main gun is the small gun, not the big gun. In Clan Wars, the small gun is the most popular. I think in random battles, the small gun is catching on as well. I think that is the main gun right now. Most people want you to play it with the small gun. You use it to hold corners. You use it to, example, if your team is pushing, playing the 1-2 line, being aggressive on the 1-2 line, you probably have an E100 or a mouse on the 9 or 0 line to protect that corner. Again, super slow heavy tanks playing in city maps, Himmelsdorf, Enns, Ruinberg. Leopard 1, very popular tank right now, playing in support positions on big maps like Steps, Live Oaks, Westfield, sniper maps that are require you to snipe from a distance. Leopard is quite popular secondary tank as well. AMX-50B, they work in pairs. Your callers normally pick two of these at any one time, and normally you play them on city maps like Enns, Himmelsdorf, Ruinberg. They work together, they go out and completely clip out an enemy tank, hide, run away, reload, and then come back, rinse and repeat. That's how they use these 50Bs. Now I put them as secondary tanks because they're not useful in all the maps, like our first five tanks here, which are just played on almost every map. 50Bs, again, city map specifics, just like the mouse, also played with, also in the secondary tank, but played on a lot on city maps. The Manticore, very popular right now. It was never popular, but it is getting very popular now because it has more than 50% camo rating if you have it fully specced up. Very good on maps like Prokhorovka, Malinovka, Murovanka, big open maps with lots of bushes. You need this sneaky spotter to do the stealth spotting for you. Object 268 version 4, this tank is the pushing tank. You use it to push all the banana road, you use it to push the corridors. You have two or three of them together, they're very useful on Enns, Himmelsdorf, Ruinberg, all these city maps. TVP 5051 is played a lot on mines. I see them shooting, clipping out medium tanks that are trying to take the hill. A lot of people play the TVP, but again, they are secondary tanks. They are played on specific situations, they do specific jobs, they work on mines, they work on cliff and those kind of maps. STB1, great hull down tank, again used for its hull down capabilities and 9, 10, 11 degrees of gun depression or whatever. I see them being used on cliff, I see them being used on Live Oaks, those kind of maps where you can use the terrain to hull down and use it as a support tank, in conjunction of the 907, of course. Supporting 907s, always close by there is a TVP, there is a STB, sorry, taking the high ground, taking the hull down position and supporting their teammates in the 907s. The STRV is played a lot on maps like Prokhorovka, Malinovka, maps where you have these STRVs taking the high ground and sniping from a distance, letting the EBR 105s do the job for them. They are the ones holding a flank in open spaces. Now in city maps, you have the mouse, you have the E100 blocking the corridors. When your team is attacking a different flank, you are defending a flank with the E100s and the mouses. On open maps, you can't use the E100s and mouses because they're so big. That's why you use the STRVs to hide from a bush, hide from a distance. they are very difficult to pan frontally, so they are the ones that are doing the blocking on open maps. Super Conquerors. Super Conquerors are secondary support tanks. Again, if you don't have a Chieftain, you might pick a Super Conqueror to play on hull down positions where heavy tanks can use the most advantage of the terrain, and that's where Super Conquerors come in. 430 use, very seldom use, but not never. I see them used maybe once in every 10-15 games. I see a 430U being selected. T92 HMC, again, one of the tanks that are almost never used, but when you are playing on the elite front and you have your Conqueror gun carriage locked, or you don't want to risk having your gun Conqueror, your CGC being locked, if you died, you play the T92, so that if you lose that tank, you get it locked in the elite front, that's okay, you still can play your CGC in the next game. The next tank, the Object 140. Object 140 is a direct replacement for the 907. Not as competitive as the 907 in terms of armor. The gun is basically the same, but the armor, the 907 has more trollish armor. Therefore, it survives a little bit better than the 140, and these are the support tanks. The E4 as well, not played very often, but on city maps like Ruinberg, Ansk, and Himmelsdorf, they can be useful. Some callers like them. The IS-7 used to be the number one heavy tank, but then it lost its space in the number one slot after the... where is the 5A? The WZ-5A took its place as the number one tank, and then the Object 277 became more popular than the 5A after it was released. Now, this video is going on for 16 minutes now, so I'm going to end this video here, but if you want to pause this video and take a picture of this setup, the way I've rated these tanks here, so that you can use it as a reference point for your future grinds. If you want to be competitive, or you want to explore trying to earn yourself reward tanks, or trying to get yourself involved in clan wars, advances, competitive gameplay, these top two tier tanks here are the ones you need. Your main battle tanks and your support tanks. These two levels of tanks here are the most important tanks that you can get for yourself. Now, it's difficult for you to get those reward tanks. Yes, I know you need to play Clan Wars events to earn these reward tanks. You need to do a lot of missions to get the 279E or the Object 260. But they're possible for you to earn. Most of these tanks are possible for you to grind out in the tech tree. So get yourself these tanks if you want to be competitive, if you want callers to select you to play for them to represent their clan, if you want to start your clan wars, global map, advances, strongholds, if you want to get that part of your game going, these are the tanks you are going to be needing in order to be competitive, in order to be consistently selected. And I hope you enjoyed this video and took some information out of it. I'll see you on the next video. Bye bye.